Hello friends, my name is Akshay Nagarguje. Today we will see circuit breakers. First, the contents of the circuit breaker, introduction, operating mechanism, type of circuit breakers, air blast circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers, oil circuit breakers and SF6 circuit breakers. Conclusion. Introduction. A circuit breaker can be operated manually and automatically. It disconnects the supply if any abnormal situation occurs in circuit. During faulty condition, switches are not sustained. But circuit breakers will have facility that faulty and abnormal condition circuit breakers can operate. Circuit breaker can make or break electrical circuit manually can be operated at all loads, that is no load, full load, short circuit conditions. A circuit breaker is a mechanical switching device capable of making, carrying and breaking current under normal condition. It also helps capable of making and carrying currents for a specified time and breaking currents under specified abnormal circuit condition such as those circuit. Next, we see the operating principle of circuit breaker. Here, as we see in figure 1, there is the FC, fixed contact, and there is MC, which is moving contact. As we see, the fixed contact is connected to the supply and the moving contact connected to the load, and these two contact connected to the handle, which is operated manually or automatically. In normal connection, fixed contact and moving contact connected normally or physically. As you see in a figure 2, when abnormal condition occurs, fixed contact move from a moving contact, and that time supply is not given to the moving contact. Here isolation takes place and the isolation forms the arc in between fixed contact and the moving contact. When abnormal condition occurs, handle moving through the moving contact and space is formed between the fixed contact and the moving contact. Circuit breakers mainly consist of fixed contact and sliding contact into which moves a moving contact. The end of moving contact is attached to handle, which can be operated manually or automatically. Next, we see the schematic of representation of circuit breaker. As we see, there is the input which is connected to the FC, which is fixed contact, and the here is the moving contact which is connected to the sliding contact, and the end of moving contact we connect the handle which is connected to the automatic operation mechanism. The handle is works on a gear and gear operation. Here is the trip coil. There is also voltage sensor relay, and there is the output which is connected to the sliding contact. When abnormal condition occurs, load current call the voltage sensor. This relay gives tripping signal to the trip coil, and the trip coil is energized. The plunger attached to the automatic mechanism, and automatic operation mechanism release mechanical energy to the kinetic energy and moving slides through the hand. When fixed contact and the moving contact separated, ionization takes place and it makes arc between the fixed contact and moving contact, as we see in the figure 2, which actually break the circuits. Next, we see the electric arc. During the separation of contact, due to large fault current and high current density, the contact region, the surrounding medium ionizes, the conducting medium is formed. This is called the arc. The factors responsible for arc. First one is potential difference between the contact, and second is the ionized particle between the contact. There are mainly two factors responsible for arc. Next, we see the types of circuit breaker. First is oil circuit breaker, vacuum circuit breaker, air blast circuit breaker and SF6 circuit breaker. First, we see oil circuit breaker. When fixed contact and moving contact placed in the oil, they are known as oil circuit breaker. It is designed for 11 kW to 756 kW. There are two types, bulk oil circuit breaker and minimum oil circuit breaker. In bulk oil circuit breaker, the oil level is maximum And in minimum oil circuit breaker, the oil level is minimum. The contacts are immersed in the oil bath. Oil provides cooling by the hydrogen created arc. It acts as a good dielectric medium and quenches the arc. As we see in the diagram, there is the oil circuit breaker. Here fixed contact, moving contact, transformer oil and the level of oil and the air cushion. There are some advantages and disadvantages of oil circuit breaker. First, see the advantages. First one is good dielectric medium. Second is low cost, which has oil easily available. Third is wide range of braking capability. These are some advantages of oil circuit breaker. Let's see the disadvantages of oil circuit breaker. There is the slow operation, takes for 27 cycles for arc quenching. This is the disadvantages of oil circuit breaker. Next we see the vacuum circuit breaker. When fixed contact and moving contact placed in the vacuum, it is known as vacuum circuit breaker. It is designed for medium voltage range 3.34 to 33 kilowatt. This consists of vacuum of pressure, which is 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 inside arc extinction chamber. The arc burns in metal vapor when the contacts are disconnected. At high voltage, its rate of dielectric strength recovery is high. Due to vacuum, arc extinction is very fast. The contacts lose metals gradually due to formation of metal vapors. Here we will see the vacuum circuit breaker diagram. There is the fixed contact and here is the moving contact. There is the arcing chamber and there is the ceramic insulator. Here is the moving contact stem and there is the mechanical coupling for operating mechanism. And it is the bellows. Here is the fixed contact stem and the fixed terminal pad. There are also some advantages of and disadvantages of the vacuum circuit breaker. First we see the advantages of the vacuum circuit breaker. It is rapid recovery of very high dielectric strength on current interruption, so that only half cycle or less arcing occurs after proper contact separation. No emission of gases, hence pollution free. Very high power frequency and impulse withstand voltage with small contact spacing, allowing ease of actuation and timing. These are the some advantages of the vacuum circuit breaker. Let's see the disadvantages of vacuum circuit breaker. First one is it needs a additional surge suppressor in a parallel with each phase for interruption of low magnetizing currents in a certain range, and it is uneconomical to manufacture vacuum interpreter in a small quantities. And third one is the loss of vacuum due to transient damage or failure makes the entire interruption useless and it cannot be repaired at site. There are some these are some disadvantages of the vacuum circuit breaker. Next we see the air blast circuit breaker. This operates using highly velocity blast of air which quenches the arc. There is axial blast type, cross blast type and the radial blast type. It consists of blast wall, blast tube and the contacts. Blast wall contains air at high pressure. Blast tube carries the air at a high pressure and opens the moving contact attached to spring. There is no carbonization of surface as in VCB, which is vacuum circuit breaker. Air should be kept clean and dry to operate it properly. Here we see air blast circuit breaker diagram. Here we see the fixed contact and there is the moving contact. Here also the spring and the piston. Here is the nozzle, exhaust valve and the arcing. There is the fixed contact of isomaker and this is the hollow insulator. Here is the wall, air receiver and the open isomaker blade. There are also some advantages and the disadvantages of the air blast circuit breaker. Let's see the advantages of air blast circuit breaker. First we see the cheapness and free availability of the interrupting medium, chemically stable and inertness of air. Next, air blast circuit breaker have advantage of high speed operation. Third one is in air blast circuit breaker, fire hazard is eliminated unlike in oil circuit breaker. It is also short and consistent arcing time and therefore less burning of contact. These are the some advantages of the air blast circuit breaker. Let's see the disadvantages of air blast circuit breaker. The first one is an air compressor plant has to be installed and maintained. Second one is in air blast circuit breaker upon the arc interruption, the air blast circuit breaker produces a high level of noise when air is discharged to the open atmosphere. And third one is there is a problem of restriking voltage. These are the some disadvantages of air blast circuit breaker. Next we see the SF6 circuit breaker. The fixed contact and the moving contact placed in the SF6 gas. So that's why it is called as SF6 circuit breaker. It contains an arc interruption chamber obtaining SF6 gas. In closed position, the contact remains surrounded by SF6 gas at pressure of 2.8 kg per cm square. Next is during opening high pressure SF6 gas at 14 kg per cm square from its reservoir flows towards the chamber by valve mechanism. SF6 rapidly absorbs the free electrons in the arc path from immobile negative ions to build up the high dielectric strength. It also cools the arc and extinguishes it. After operation, the valve is enclosed by the action of set of spring. The absorbed material are used to absorb the byproduct and moisture. Let's see the advantages and the disadvantages of SF6 circuit breaker. First, we see the advantages of SF6 circuit breaker. First one is, it is very short arcing period due to superior arc quenching property of SF6. Second one is, can interrupt much larger current as compared to the other breakers. Third one is, there is no risk of fire. And it has low maintenance and light foundation. Fourth one is no overvoltage problem and there are no carbon deposits. So these are the some advantages of SF6 circuit breaker. Let's see the disadvantages of SF6 circuit breaker. There are two disadvantages of the SF6 circuit breaker. First one is SF6 breakers are costly due to high cost of SF6, and second one is SF6 gas has to be reconditioned after every operation of the circuit breaker. Additional equipment is required for this purpose. Lastly, we conclude that the circuit breaker is the most essential part of the electrical network as it protects every device from damage. It helps us to detect the fault and area affected by it. Nowadays, vacuum and SF6 circuit breaker are widely used due to their reliable and fast operation. Thank you.